Hey! Hey there, buddy!
Hey, pal! What's
going
on? I am fantastic. Where are you heading?
Well, actually, I was heading to Vacation Bible School.
Vacation Bible School?
Absolutely.
Well, sounds like a fun time.
Oh, it's gonna be super.
Super time. Ooh, speaking of super.
Yeah?
You know what that means.
What? Well, actually, yeah. Hey, do you see that crane? It looks like it's gonna drop some concrete.
Well, it sure does. You reckon we should do something?
I reckon it's time for Super Guy and Super Pal.
Yeah.
And now,
I am feeling the power! Oh!
Man, you know, it's really a great thing to be able to have these superpowers and nobody recognizes because we're
yes,
wearing
it is.
Masks.
Totally unrecognizable.
Occasionally, I'd like to get some of the credit for saving people and...
Yes,
but,
yes.
You know, it's part of the job, I guess. Uh-oh.
Now, where's this Vacation Bible School?
Well, Guy,
what's that?
Are y'all okay?
Ooh.
That concrete just fell on that man's car. Everybody looks okay,
yeah, it's
going
to do a lot of damage over there.
Yes, I hope it's insured.
Yeah. Sorry about that.
We might oughta.
We got somewhere to go.
Yeah, it's. Let's go on to Vacation Bible School.
We're gonna have a super time at Vacation Bible School.
Absolutely.
At Vacation Bible School.
Let's go.
Ready? We going that way?
The big day came. Renzo Wright, boy genius and youngest architect in the country, was chosen to make the largest building in the world. It was his first day on the job, and it's fair to say he was a little intimidated, which is just a fancy word for nervous.
It's a lot taller than I imagined it.
We need more blockos.
Renzo Tower, world's biggest building, coming soon. Pressure is on the boy, genius.
I'm not worried at all. No problem.
The first skyscraper was built over 100 years ago and reached 10 stories tall. Today on this site, Renzo Wright shall build for Kitten Construction, Inc., the tallest and best building ever. Isn't that right, young man?
Yes, ma'am. I will build it perfectly.
He's going up to the clouds. Let's go again!
Lloyd!
With the opening ceremony over, it was time to meet the construction foreman, Mr. Santiago. Mr. Santiago believed in Renzo's plan completely.
Worst plans I've ever seen.
All due respect, Mr. Santiago, I spent the whole weekend making those.
Yeah, 170 stories, huh?
Can I drive the blue thingy?
Huh? Son, you should not operate anything out here.
It's 171 stories, actually. Check out the treehouse deck.
Look, kid, this is a heavy construction. Cranes and concrete. Building a skyscraper means deadlines, hard work, and always following the rules. We've got a lot to do in a short time.
I know all this. I've built lots of buildings.
With toy blocks, not real machines.
I'm not operating on it. I'm driving it.
Cease operation! Cease operation!
It's a bulldozer, but it seems wide awake!
Kid, get down from there! Get down from there!
Santiago, allow me to demonstrate my serious skills.
Lorenzo, what are you doing?
Proving my worth!
Oh! Lloyd, cease operations!
I'm digging for worms! Digging for worms!
No!
Mr. Santiago, it isn't safe for you!
It isn't safe for me?
There really should be an age limit out here.
Stop this crazy thing!
Say, Mr. Santiago, where's the off button?
Oh, melted rainbow!
I suppose I should learn a few more things before I start giving orders.
Giving orders? Giving orders? Why, I... You ought to be given apologies.
If you want to make an omelet, you gotta break a few eggs, Mr. Santiago.
Omelet? Omelet?
Santiago, what are you doing making a mess out here? Embarrassing us in front of the genius kid. Go clean yourself up.
Nine.
Renzo, we have a problem.
Extra! Extra! Cobra Cone Construction promises to build bigger, better, and faster than Boy Genius. Read all about it. Extra!
If you want to keep your special floor, you got to deliver bigger, faster, and better.
For the first time in his life, Renzo needed help. The truth is, Renzo really messed up, but he was not ready to admit it. Pride is a tricky thing. It causes all kinds of problems. Renzo had a lot to learn about asking for forgiveness. But fortunately, someone in his life was praying. And maybe it's not who you think.
Lord, please, help us forgive this boy. Give me patience with him. If we could survive him, that would be good too.
Hey guys, Miss Kim here. It's so good to be back with you tonight. I hope you have had fun learning your Bible verse using the motions that I taught you. Let's do it together right now. I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. Philippians 1:6. Tonight, I'm going to show you another fun way to hide God's word in your heart. First, you take a piece of paper and you write your verse on it, and then cut it up into pieces like a puzzle. Now I can have fun and work on my verse at the same time. Let me show you. I have my puzzle pieces right here so that you can see it. I'm going to put it together and I'm going to say the verse as I'm working it to help me remember. I am sure. Here's I am sure of this, that he who, oh, I am sure of this. Let me put this part up there. This is harder than I thought it would be. I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you, let me go ahead and put this together. Then it'll be easier to read. All right, there we go. I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus, Philippians 1:6. Now, you read it with me and do the motions from yesterday if you want to. I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you will carry it to completion until the day of Christ Jesus, Philippians 1:6. Now, parents, you can make the puzzle easier or harder by having fewer or more pieces depending on the age of your child. Have a race to see who can put it together the fastest. Remember to have someone take pictures or video you to send in. It will be fun to see all of you working on your verse. Don't forget your day 2 craft and snack so that you can make it with your parents after the VBS worship rally experience. See you tomorrow night with another fun way to help you memorize your verse.
Hey guys, welcome back to worship. Tonight, you are learning about the foundation of forgiveness. And one thing we can do when we sing to God is feel the forgiveness that He offers. So get up on your feet. Let's sing and dance and worship God together.
Admit to God that you're a sinner and repent. Be again, boys and girls. We are so glad that you're with us again for Vacation Bible School. Have you guys been thinking about who you want to show love and kindness to by delivering them some muffins? In the Bible, in John chapter 13, verse 34, Jesus said, "I give you a new command. Love one another just as I have loved you. You are also to love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you love one another." In Mark chapter 12, verse 31, the Bible says, "Love your neighbor as yourself." You may have heard this verse before, to love your neighbor as yourself, but what does it really mean? While your neighbor isn't just the person who lives next door, your neighbor can be a bus driver, a teacher, or maybe it's just your friend that you play with down the street. If you show them love, you are obeying God's commandments. Remember, we are on mission this week. We are the missionaries. We get to go out and show God's love to others in our community. I really hope you guys have been thinking about and praying about and making sure you're talking with an adult about when you can make your muffins and take them to the special person or people that God has placed on your heart. Remember to take pictures and videos for me because I really want to see you all being real live missionaries and showing love and kindness to people. Tomorrow, I'm going to be back here at VBS with you guys, but I am bringing missionaries with me. And those missionaries are my kids. And we are going to mix up muffins tomorrow and show you how fun and easy it is. We'll see you guys in the kitchen tomorrow.
Hey guys, welcome to night two of Vacation Bible School. Last night, we kicked off our time together with the story that focused on a biblical truth that none of us are good enough to earn the love of Jesus, that Jesus chooses to love us, period. Well, today, I'm going to share another story that will go to the other extreme to say that Jesus loves us regardless of our sin. Well, you might say, "Miss Jamie, you don't even know my sins. You don't even know what I've done. My mama doesn't even know the mistakes I've made." Well, even though I don't know what you've done, God does, and He loves you. Romans 5:8 says, "While we were still sinners, Christ died for us." And tonight's story is about a man that sometimes goes by the name of Paul and other times by the name of Saul. God had big plans for this guy, but he had a bunch of big mistakes. If you have your Bibles close by, you can find this story in Acts chapter 26, verses 1 through 29. There is so much about Paul I could share with you. Paul didn't actually love or believe in Jesus before God stopped him in his tracks. God was now giving Paul a grand stage to share his story, and more importantly, the story of Jesus. Paul had been chosen by God to tell the good news of Jesus to the Gentiles. You know, the people who weren't Jews. Paul traveled thousands of miles telling people about Jesus and starting churches. This made some people angry, so they had him arrested. However, instead of being angry, Paul knew he could use his arrest to talk to many very important government officials about Jesus. While Paul was in prison, King Agrippa came to visit Festus, the local governor. Festus told the king about Paul, and the king asked to see Paul and listen to his story. Paul began by reminding everyone that he'd grown up in Jerusalem and strictly followed the laws and the rules of the Pharisees. He spoke out against Jesus, and he placed many people who were followers of Jesus in jail. He even supported the ruler's decision to put Jesus' followers to death. Then Paul told about a day that he had been traveling to Damascus to arrest believers in Jesus. "King Agrippa," Paul said, "I was walking along the road about midday when I saw a light brighter than the sun. I fell to the ground, and so did all the people traveling with me. I heard a voice speak to me. The voice said, 'Why are you persecuting me?'" Paul explained that he was confused because he didn't see anyone, So he asked, "Who was speaking?" The voice replied, "I am Jesus, the one you are persecuting." Jesus told Paul that he had been chosen to go and tell the Gentiles how they could have faith in Jesus and receive forgiveness of sin. Paul then explained to King Agrippa that he obeyed that voice and told people everywhere that Jesus, the Messiah, suffered and died, but rose again. Paul explained how God had helped him. Paul told the king that everything he said was true. King Agrippa asked Paul, "Are you trying to convince me to become a Christian too?" Paul replied, "I truly wish that not only you, but that everyone who listens to this message would believe in Jesus." Paul had done some really, really bad things to the people that followed and believed in Jesus. But it didn't stop God from choosing Paul to take this message of Jesus to an entirely different people group. The Bible refers to the people who are not Jews as Gentiles. And guess what? That's you and me. In fact, that's all people that live in the world, regardless if they're a boy or a girl, if they have light skin or if they have dark skin, if they live in my neighborhood or they live across the world. In Acts 16:31, Paul says, "Believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved, you and your household." This was Paul's mission now that Jesus had changed his entire life. God chose Paul even though we might think Paul wasn't good enough or he'd done too many bad things. I mean, in fact, throughout the New Testament and our history today, millions upon millions of people have come to believe in Jesus because Paul said yes when God called his name. I am so thankful that Paul chose to take the good news of Jesus to the Gentiles. Woohoo! I mean, that is so awesome. All right, guys. Well, that's it for now, but I will see you back here tomorrow night. Bye.
Hey, kids and parents, what a great night. Tonight, I want to draw your attention to the parent guide. Parents, I hope that you grab this in the kit that you received because in it are some great tips for establishing or developing a family devotion time. And that's one of the neat things about us doing an at-home VBS experience this year is that it may help you to develop some of these rhythms that you've always wished that you had. So take some time and read through the book because it'll give you a great foundation and some guidelines for putting together a regular family devotional time with your kids every week. Now, we hope to see you back tomorrow night. But in the meantime, again, take some pictures, shoot some videos, and share them with us so we can share them on Thursday night. See you tomorrow night.